last words we hear from the honoree. Mama. First of all, I would like to give honor to God, to the minister here that allowed my daughter to have this beautiful celebration. I thank everybody that came, and being a mom, 8 children, 6 girls, and 2 boys, 2 sons, was a big blessing of God. It really was a surprise to me also, because I used to say that I wasn't going to have a lot of kids, but God knew
yes, he did.
What I needed. And as far as Judith has always, like everybody have almost said what she's been all her life. As a little girl, being a mother of 8 children, and particularly girls, anyone have daughters know how petty they are. One of the big obstacles of the day was, Mama make so-and-so hurry up and come out of the bathroom. Because in those days, we didn't have 2 and 3 and 4 bathrooms like we do today. Judy have always been very highly competitive. Whatever that teacher said, it was the gospel. After getting up early, getting my family off, and sitting down for a second, everybody would be gone, but I would suddenly hear that side door knock. And it was, Mama, I've got to have that. Ms. Wallace said, we all, and she was, I guess, born to be highly competitive. She was in accelerated courses in school, and I said, Judy, you can't always be top. Sometimes it doesn't work out that way, but not telling Judy that. Judy was determined. I have 6 girls, and they all had different personalities, very different personalities. Judy was the type that was, as she say, Mom, I got it from you. She never knew to say no. Anytime somebody would ask her to do something, she would always volunteer and do it. I see some of her childhood friends here. All her college friends, I always heard about this famous, and I used to come and see you guys sing, and it's really a pleasure what I saw tonight. To the young lady that played a cello, Julie used to play a viola, I'm sorry to say. She was in first year, she did it till she got to high school, and she always wanted to get out of it, okay? But when she got into college program up at Oakland University, she had to have another math course. So that's how she got out of it. Then after a little while, she was so sorry that she did. But God had another plan for her that she didn't even know. In my family, there's a musical trait. My daughter sang, and Judy's father was a musician. That's where she got her talent from. Judy's grandfather was a minister for many, many years, and his mother played the piano. How Judy really got into singing is one of her older sisters used to sing all the time. And some of our high school friends were into the music business, and they came down to the house one day to get this one daughter that was singing, and she wasn't home. So he said, Miss Thurman, I gotta go down to the studio and is in anybody, any of the Lord is conceived, said it was so important to them, because I think they was going to make a recording. Judy volunteered, and that's how she started. She came from an instrument into singing. For many, many years, and she just loves to sing. And she loves to work with people and kids. She never denied anybody. She's like me. And she said, "Mom, you can't talk because you don't know how to say no either." All you had to do is ask her to do something. She loves her family, and she loves the Lord. I like where she said that she didn't know the Lord. She didn't know him like she do now. Because one thing in my family, they had to go to church until they were 18 years old. They had a choice of their own after, but up until 18, every Sunday, we all went to church. And when she said that, I could tell the maturity is she grew older because some of the churches she made her own choice. She loves her church family. They are, well, they're our family also, because I hear about Pastor Nelson and this church every time he comes home. But God has been good to her, and I hope she continue her gift that God has given her, and I thank everyone for coming out and supporting her. Thank you.